Alcohol. In all cases, it is important to get the addictive biochemistry of a situation. There are several types of alcoholics, which was first posed by Joan Matthews Larson and will be expanded upon here. Number 1. Anxiety related. 2. Hypoglycemic. 3. Allergic addicted. And 4. Endorphin deficient. It is important to know what kind of alcoholic a person is so that you can create a working strategy. Without knowledge of the addiction and correction of the underlying addictive biochemistry, a person often falls back into the same trap. Anxiety related. Most everyone who has a drinking problem has anxiety. The type of anxiety we are highlighting here involves a reasonably constant type of anxiety that does not come or go. This type of person is self-medicating to lessen anxiety so that they can function. We are not talking about the anxiety that comes up first thing in the morning or directly after their alcohol levels drop. We are talking about people that have anxiety for long periods of time, even when they are not drinking. These folks are probably plugged up with excitotoxins and need to address that underlying toxicity. Hypoglycemic. Alcohol is a liquid sugar. It does not even need to be digested, as the sugar alcohol passes straight from the stomach and into the bloodstream. If a person is experiencing low blood sugar, the craving is, of course, for sugar, and even more potently, alcohol. You can spot these folks often because without alcohol, they gravitate towards sugar and coffee, which is the same addictive biochemistry. The drinking pattern is usually a person who drinks coffee the first thing in the morning, and if they eat in the morning at all, it is likely sugar-based. Then, at some point in the afternoon, the blood sugar plummets and they drink. They often present as the all-day, everyday type of drinker that keeps a steady state alcohol level. Unfortunately, the AA programs support this addictive biochemistry by serving donuts and coffee at meetings. The philosophical aspects of AA are fabulous. The attention to the addictive biochemistry is not. To break this pattern, it is going to take several months of dedicated effort. A person should eat protein-based breakfast every morning and eat at least 3 times per day, avoiding sugar. Coffee should be avoided for the first several months, and if added, which is not recommended, should only be consumed after eating breakfast. The power of a blood sugar drop to create cravings for alcohol is a brain survival mechanism that will overpower even the best of them. The vast majority of persons who do not put attention to their diet white-knuckle their recovery until they eventually relapse. If you want to break the hypoglycemic addiction to alcohol, you will break the addiction to sugar by addressing hypoglycemia. Hypoglycemic dispositions can occur in combination with any of the other dispositions, and any person suffering from alcohol should respect these basic tenets. Allergic addicted. When a person is allergic to alcohol, the inflammatory reaction releases endorphins and the person gets addicted to their own endorphins. You can spot this type of person because they have a very low alcohol tolerance before their mood turns. Any nationality can have this disposition, but it is more common in the Native American and Asian populations. Binge drinkers often fall into this category. The fix for this is the same recommendations given in the endorphin opiate section. Endorphin deficient, THIQ. Technically, the allergic addicted is an endorphin deficient disposition. What is unique about the THIQ disposition is the drinking pattern and the mechanism. THIQ is an opiate-like compound that is produced in small amounts during the breakdown of alcohol. But you have to drink a lot to get there. These folks have a fantastic liver and can convert alcohol extremely well. You can spot these folks as they are the ones that can drink ridiculous amounts of alcohol and still be standing. The THIQ, as an opiate, can lower the social anxiety, and these types of folks are generally the life of the party. Eventually, the party stops, and the body breaks down, and they find themselves stuck. The correction for this type of drinker is the same as those given in the endorphin opiate section. To address alcohol issues, supplements. Address endorphin deficient issues as mentioned in the endorphin section. Add B vitamins, specifically B1, B2, B5, and niacin, as alcohol burns up B vitamins. You can take 500 milligrams of niacin every time there is a craving. Toxic impairment. Stop smoking if possible, as cigarettes are often cured with sugar. At least switch to American spirits, which are additive-free. Diet. Eliminate sugar and caffeine. Include protein-based foods. Follow the recommendations regarding hypoglycemia. This is the most important point to take in. Eat and/or drink water if there's a craving. Thirst and hunger are often confused with alcohol cravings. Environment. Get into a supportive community. That might be AA, church, yoga, or any other community a person is attracted to. It is not good to get lonely or bored in early recovery.